This is 10 News. Smokers will be forced to butt out in one of Melbourne's most popular laneways as part of a six-month trial. The ban could lead to the policy reform across the state. Candace Wyatt joins us live now from the Causeway. So, Candace, why has the City of Melbourne made this move?
Mel, the council says it spoke to traders and customers here and received a positive response to the idea, but more broadly, it came from the Australian Medical Association, which has become increasingly annoyed that Victoria has done nothing about alfresco smoking, while other states have had bans in place for years.
The drawbacks of smoking are well known. But in the Causeway at least, it will soon be banned.
Like after uni, I'll have to come down here and have a coffee and enjoy myself with a cigarette as well.
As part of a six-month trial, Melbourne City Council will not allow smoking in the lane that runs between Little Collins Street and the Bourke Street Mall.
Personally, I'd like to see further trials extended to other alfresco dining areas, but once again, we're very keen to see the results in the Causeway.
Councillor Richard Fowler used to smoke and pushed for the ban, but he says there will be no penalties for smokers who light up.
Enforcement is going to be very, very soft. We're encouraging a self-compliance regime. We won't be issuing infringements. We won't be fining people.
Traders expect the lack of lingering cigarette smoke to increase business.
I'm happy all round.
Times have changed, haven't they?
Times have changed. We've got to move. Yeah, we've got to move. We've got to modernise.
For non-smokers, it's a welcome relief.
The lane was a bit squeezed and the smoke gets around, so yeah, it's quite annoying when you're trying to eat and someone's smoking next to you.
The idea came from the Australian Medical Association, which argues Victoria is lagging behind other states on outdoor smoking reform.
The reason why other states do this is because they've understood and accepted the evidence that passive smoking is very harmful.
And soon, Victoria could be doing it too.
The ban will start next month and run until March next year. The results will then go to the council in May, and from there we could expect more permanent bans across the City of Melbourne or indeed wider Victoria. Mel?
Candace Wyatt from the Causeway in the city. And you can tell us if you'd like to see a citywide smoking ban on Twitter @10NewsMelb or Facebook / 10NewsMelbourne.